free. So there was this wise one who loved all the haters, loved them so much that their head turned to fear. People from beyond the gutters and the ones to hear.
So Stan walked towards the cave, and in his mind, mark your word, land job. Deep thought was this, while the tremble owed, looking into the dark and peering into the back grove of black in there, and then appeared Lad John, in fine, fine, foldy silken robes. All white the hair, scintillating beard and dangling, and the beard must have been 3 to 4 years old to grow in the world. And he was glowing with a friendly light, and a joy, and a voice full of the cockney, 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 and all joy of life and living emanate from the copper of his heartstrings. Come to see you, man. What's been your hang-up, man, huh? I'm waiting 7 whole days for you. Not still worried about the scintillating moon and dangling, huh? Sam, yes. That's why I sought you out here. The tricky, tricky how in the back of this blind, you told me. And John linked arms with him, and walking out, stepper by stepper, and he pointed with a cockney forefinger. There, up in the heavenly road. What? Stan realised, now, which had struck him like a smacker of bloody, which coming out from the turn he never thought was before. As the sun rise in the early morning, so the recoil of the moon on the eve. And he thought. Now, the fly had something extra special you thought was to say to me, if you would. And John, crooked hat in, and attracting his earnestly of his eyeballs, straight nose to nose, and eye to eyeball for it. Of course, I nearly forgot it. Just you miss.
Newspaper geek and jutty smile. They all had a lucky turn up. Gnomes came,